Hi, I'm Matt Darr with Iowa State University in the Department of Agricultural and Biosystems Engineering. After the derecho event hit Iowa in early August, we've had several questions about how to manage the amount of residue that's left in the fields. We put together a field demonstration to evaluate a number of different tillage tools to help provide some insight into what those options look like. Today, we're back in that same field 5 days later to take a look at what the residue in the ground looks like post the tillage applications. The first thing we have to consider in these unharvestable fields is what are we doing with the residue size? As a combine goes through the field, it's going to naturally reduce the size of residue and get it evenly spread across the field. As we look at these different tillage tools, we're going to pay special attention to how well those tools do to chop up and distribute the residue and help us get prepared for a successful spring next year. In this area of the field, we tilled it with a shallow gang angle vertical tillage tool, or a VT tool. We used a less than 5 degree gang angle to avoid much soil incorporation, but really do a really good job of chopping that residue. The majority of this residue is down in the 6 to 8 inch size range. And the field really looks like it would normally look like after the combine had gone through the field. Now, since there's very little soil incorporation, if we're gonna seed a cover crop into this, we really need to have a drill or some way to get seed to soil contact. Broadcast spreading would not be very effective given the mat of residue that we still have on the ground. In this part of the field, we used an aggressive VT tool set up at a 10 degree gang angle. This configuration helped us to consistently chop stalk residue, and we ended up with pieces that were consistently in the 6 to 8 to 12 inch range. The aggressive setting here also did more soil incorporation than we saw in the low gang angle VT trial. In this case, I'd estimate about 75% ground cover after the VT tool went through the field. For a cover crop application, we'd still recommend using a drill in this situation because of the amount of ground cover that we have. I do think that this field is could be planted right into next spring after overwintering if we have the appropriate tool set with row cleaners and potentially row tillage on the planter. We're in the area of the field where the high-speed disc ran, and one of the first things I noticed is the amount of soil and residue incorporation that happened. The high-speed disc appears to do a very good job of chopping up this standing residue and getting enough soil incorporated to help with decomposition and breakdown of the material. The majority of the stalks that we're seeing are between 6 to 8 inches long, and there's a few longer stalks, but overall, again, the residue is chopped pretty finely. The additional soil that's been exposed and mixed is going to help with cover crop seeding. This would certainly be an area where you could come in and simply broadcast seed that cover crop. And with a rain or two, this is likely to get a nice stand. Additionally, by mixing in the ears with the soil, we would expect that, again, with a little bit of rain, we've got a good chance to get some of these kernels to germinate and avoid being volunteer corn next year. We're out in the area of the field where we ran a disc ripper. And originally we ran a traditional ripper and, of course, quickly plugged it due to the length of material that was out here. We then removed and modified the machine by pulling off the ripper standards and just leveraging the aggressiveness of the front disc. This was very successful in incorporating residue into the soil. We didn't have any issues with plugging, and the wide stance of the disc at 18 inches apart still did an effective job of cutting residue, chopping residue, although the residue is a little bit longer than other practices because of the wide spacing on those discs. This field would easily be seeded with a cover crop with a broadcast spreader with a little bit of rain, and the amount of incorporation we've achieved here should help us germinate some of this corn to avoid it becoming a volunteer weed next year. The tillage tool that you're going to use to help process this unharvestable corn is really all about what kind of outcomes you're after, and hopefully the different tools that we explained and demonstrated here give you a little insight into the options that are available and what you might use to achieve your goals.